When Sugar Ray Robinson was asked who hit him the hardest, he gave a surprise answer. Artie Levine. It was November 6, 1946. Robinson was in his prime at 26 years of age, while Levine was 21, and both were highly regarded contenders, with Sugar Ray installed as the 4-1 favorite. But Levine was no slouch. He was trained by Charlie Goldman, who would later go on to train Rocky Marciano, and for the Robinson bout, he would be trained by Ray Arcel, who would later be known as the trainer of Roberto Duran. But it was in the fifth round that Levine would etch his name in boxing history when he caught Sugar Ray with a left hook that, in Sugar Ray's own words, left him flopping like a fish. The referee walked Levine to the neutral corner, then walked back to Robinson, picking up the count at 1. Robinson was up at the count of 9, so he was actually down for 19 and 20 seconds. The left hook had scrambled his brain so much that Robinson would forget what round it was. He would fight on, and by the 8th round, his manager, George Gainford, was begging him, "You gotta beat this guy." "I've got plenty of time," Robinson replied. "Plenty of time," his manager growled. "It's the 8th round." 8th round. I thought it was the 4th. In the 9th round, Levine would stagger Robinson again. By the 10th round, Robinson knew what he had to do. He dug hooks into Levine's stomach, staggering his opponent into the ropes and battering away until Levine was left helpless on the lower rope. He would be counted out with only 19 seconds to go. Levine described his experience with Robinson in an interview with Ring Magazine. He said, "I can describe it best in one word. Awesome. I respected Robinson. I knew he was a great fighter, but I was out to win the fight. I was in great shape. Ray Arcel, a perfectionist as far as conditioning was concerned, trained me for the fight. In the ring with Robinson, it was like fighting a machine. He was ahead of you all the way, very sharp. And you don't get any openings with Ray. He's moving away from you. And as you were getting off a punch, he would touch you on the shoulder, knocking you off balance and killing the punch." Levine would later say that he wasn't the same fighter when he fought Robinson in November of 1946, because in March of that same year, he knocked out the Jack Johnson-trained Jimmy Doyle in the 9th round of a brutal slugfest. After the fight, Doyle was carried back to his dressing room on a stretcher, and this affected Levine. Amazingly, Doyle would return to the ring and be killed by Sugar Ray Robinson in a challenge for the title only 2 years later. Feeling guilty for injuring Doyle and feeling that he softened him up for Robinson's beating, Levine claimed that he was never the same fighter. In an interview with Ring Magazine, he said, "If I didn't knock them out with one punch, I couldn't finish them off. I would tense up. In other words, the killer instinct wasn't there anymore. All because I hurt Doyle. I was never the same when I had a man hurt. By the time I fought Robinson, I was on my way down." But Levine would campaign for 3 more years after his tussle with Robinson, retiring at the age of 24 in 1949, following 3 losses in a row. The last loss, he would be knocked out in the 8th round by Dick Wagner. He would later go into business for himself and become a car salesman for Volkswagen in his native New York. His final record was 53 wins against 15 losses, 4 draws, with 38 knockouts.